The H9000 is an incredibly versatile audio tool, useful in professional recording studios, post-production and front-of-house applications, and live performance. It offers a variety of digital and analog I/O options, pristine analog-to-digital conversion, audio interface capabilities, and more. In this video, we'll show you some of the H9000's audio I/O possibilities. Let's start by taking a look at the audio connections on the back panel. Analog I/O. The H9000 includes a pair of XLR ins and outs, as well as 8 channels of balanced audio via DB25 connectors. Each pair of analog inputs and outputs on the D-sub connectors can be separately selected between -10 dBV and +4 dBU. The stereo XLR pairs are duplicates of channels 1 and 2 of the D-sub connectors, so any changes you make for analog channels 1 and 2 will affect both the stereo XLR connectors and the first two channels of the D-sub connectors. Digital audio mode. The H9000 contains several digital audio connections. Available choices include ADAT, AES using XLR or DB25 connectors, and SPDIF using RCA or optical connectors. Note, only one digital audio mode can be used at a time. This will be selected in the setup menu on the front panel or in Emote. Your selected digital audio format will determine how many channels of digital audio you can use. The AES EBU DB25 connection allows you to feed the H9000 with 8 channels of AES EBU digital audio, and also allows the unit to output 8 channels, all within a single D-sub connector. Alternatively, the H9000 can receive and send 2 channels of digital audio via the AES EBU 2-channel XLR I/O. The optical in and out ports allow you to send and receive 8 channels of audio via ADAT format. 2 channels of SPDIF I/O can be sent to and from the H9000 using the optical I/O or the RCA connectors. Note that SPDIF optical and ADAT only support sample rates of 44.1 or 48 kHz. They are not operational when the H9000 is set to run at higher sample rates of 88.2 or 96 kHz. Also note that the H9000 does not support sample rate conversion. If you want to feed the H9000 a digital audio signal, the external digital signal and the H9000 must both be locked to the same digital clock at the same sample rate. USB. The H9000 can stream 16 channels of I/O to and from your computer using the USB B port on the back panel, serving as a powerful outboard effects processor for your DAW. It can also be used as an audio interface, allowing any of the analog, digital, or expansion card I/O to be fed to the inputs of your DAW. Note that the USB B connection is only used for using the H9000 16-channel audio interface capabilities. The H9000 cannot connect to the Emote control software via USB. We'll be discussing connecting your H9000 to Emote in another video. Using the Direct I/O router, you can easily choose the routing that fits your workflow. Later in this video, we'll demonstrate this by showing how to set up the H9000 as an audio interface. A note on USB sample rates. From the point of view of the computer, the H9000 is always the clock source. However, it is not possible for the H9000 to enforce the sample rate of the computer to match its own. Therefore, you will have to manually set the computer sample rate. When switching to a new sample rate, you should first change the H9000 sample rate by selecting a different internal clock source or changing the sample rate of an external source such as ADAT, Dante, etc. Then change the H9000 USB audio sample rate in your computer settings. If the H9000 detects that the sample rates don't match, it will mute the USB audio interface and display a warning on the front panel and in Emote. When the sample rates match again, the warning message will be cleared and the audio unmuted. If you change the sample rate in the DAW first, you'll have to change it again once the H9000's clock is changed to match. This is because the H9000 cannot force the computer to resync at the new rate. The computer has to initiate this process. Note that the H9000 is not a traditional standalone computer interface with control monitoring functions. As a result, you will likely want to use the H9000's computer connectivity in conjunction with your main audio interface. If you're on a Mac, you can use their core audio system to combine multiple audio interfaces into one large device called an aggregate device. Doing so lets you use your main audio interface and its monitoring capabilities as you always have, while also having the H9000's 16 channels of I/O available to process tracks within your DAW session. To create an aggregate device, navigate your Applications folder to Utilities and then launch Audio MIDI Setup. In the Audio Devices window that appears, you should see entries for H9000 USB audio and any other computer audio interfaces you have connected, as well as the computer's built-in audio output. Click on the plus icon in the lower left-hand corner, and in the aggregate device configuration window that appears, select the appropriate I/O for the different devices you wish to use. You now have the 16 channels of the H9000's USB I/O combined with the I/O of your main audio interface, all available to use in your DAW session as needed. Ensure that the H9000's internal sample rate matches the sample rate shown in both the aggregate device and H9000 USB audio device, as well as your digital audio workstation. In your DAW of choice, select the aggregate device as your audio interface for the DAW to use. If you're using Windows, you must install the Windows driver, which can be downloaded at eventideaudio.com. After installing the driver, reboot your computer and the H9000 will appear as an audio device in the Windows Devices and Printers control panel. Its audio inputs and outputs can now be used from any ASIO-compatible software. The H9000's MIDI I/O are also now available to any software that works with MIDI ports. To set the sample rate on the H9000 using Windows 10, navigate to Windows Sound Settings, Sound Control Panel. Under the Playback tab, right-click H9000 USB Audio Expander and click Properties. The Speaker Properties window will appear. In the Speaker Properties window, click the Advanced tab. Select the appropriate sample rate and click Apply. In the Sound Control Panel under the Recording tab, right-click H9000 USB Audio Expander, Properties, click the Advanced tab, and select the sample rate, and click Apply. Expansion cards. The H9000 also offers additional I/O via three expansion card slots. Each card supports up to 32 channels of bidirectional audio. Once installed, they will be listed in Emote's Devices view and will appear as I/O channels within Emote. There are expansion cards available for MADI, Dante, and Pro Tools HD formats. You can use any combination of expansion cards, for example, two Dante and one MADI. The expansion cards allow for up to 96 channels of additional I/O, 32 channels per expansion card. Routing audio. Now let's take a closer look at how the audio is routed inside the H9000. The Effects Chains page is where you will route audio to be processed by the H9000's unique effect algorithms. Each FX chain has a total of 32 I/O and can use a combination of I/O from any available source. For example, you can have analog inputs 3 and 4 going to FX chain 1, digital inputs going to FX chain 2, and USB channels from your DAW going to FX chain 3. You can even have multiple I/O sources feed the same FX chain. In Emote, the green banner at the top of the Effects Chains page will include all of your input options: analog, digital, USB, and/or expansion cards. In this example, we will connect analog inputs 1 and 2 to Effects Chain inputs 1 and 2. We can now process analog inputs 1 and 2 with up to 4 algorithms by routing them within the Effects Chain. Similarly, at the bottom of the Effects Chain page, we will connect the output of the effects chain to a physical output of the H9000. Connecting the effects chain outputs 1 and 2 to the H9000's analog outputs 1 and 2 will route the audio to the H9000's XLR outputs. Alternatively, we can choose to route effects chain outputs 1 and 2 to the H9000's USB outputs. Using this I/O configuration, we can connect external instruments to the H9000's XLR inputs, process them through an effects chain, and record them directly into a DAW via USB. Direct I/O. Using the Direct I/O feature, you are able to route direct audio pathways between any input and output, allowing you to use your H9000 as a virtual patch bay. Even when you're not using the H9000 for effects, you can still take advantage of the H9000's pristine analog to digital and digital to analog converters. In this example, we'll show you how to set up the H9000 as an audio interface. In the Direct I/O view page, we'll start by routing USB inputs 1 and 2 to analog outputs 1 and 2. This will create a pathway from our DAW's master outputs to the H9000's XLR outputs and out to our studio monitors. Next, we'll connect the analog inputs 1 and 2 to the USB outputs 1 and 2. This will allow us to connect external signals to the H9000's XLR inputs that will be directly routed to our DAW's inputs, bypassing the H9000's effect processor while still taking advantage of its pristine analog converters. These are just some of the ways the H9000 can easily be incorporated into your existing workflow. We encourage you to share the ways you use the H9000 on the EventideAudio.com Rack Mount Forum. We hope this video was helpful in demystifying the fabulous flexibility of the H9000. If you'd like to see a different tutorial, please let us know what you'd like to learn in the comments section below. Thanks for watching.